Hello buddy, welcome back to another video, and in this video I'm gonna be showing you how to use the scoreboard command in Minecraft. So I'll go over the scoreboard command in both Java and Bedrock Edition. In Java Edition there are many more features as normal, and in Bedrock Edition there's, well, not much customization, but we'll go over what you can do there as well. And if you like videos like this, please make sure to like the video and consider subscribing to my channel. But let's just get started with the basic scoreboard command. So if you type in scoreboard, you will get two options over here. We have objectives and players. So what you first need to do is add an objective. So add objectives, and then we have five different options: add, list, modify, remove, and set display. Of course, there are no scoreboards initially, so you have to add them yourself. And I have a command block over here that will add a armor scoreboard. So over here you can just add the name of your scoreboard. This one is the one that shows up, so we will call this amount of armor. Of course, if you want spaces, you can't do it like this, so for now let's just call it armor. Later on I will show you how to actually add spaces to your scoreboard names. And then over here is the criteria. So this is in this case armor, but there are lots of different things you can add over here. So if you just type in the scoreboard ourselves, add name, here are all the different criteria you can add. So the amount of area you have left, armor, the amount of deaths you have, dummy, which won't increase with anything, only if you use commands. And this is also the only thing that's available in Bedrock Edition, the dummy criteria. Then you have food, health, if you're killed by a different team, your XP level, if you've broken any of these things. And then there are multiple options there as well. So you have broken, you have crafted. So crafted is just how many times you crafted a certain item. You have custom. Custom are all the statistics stuff. So the amount of animals you've bred, the amount of bells you've rung, and all of these kinds of things. The amount of centimeters you've crouched, and much, much more. You also have the amount of items you've dropped. So you can check for if the player drops an item and stuff like that. You can track the amount of mobs you've killed, and also the amount of mobs that have killed you by doing killed by, like this. There are many different options. Let's go through the rest of them. If you've mined certain blocks, if you've picked up certain items, if you've used certain items, and that's all that I know of on those. There are also a couple more here, like player kill count, so that's the amount of players you have killed, the amount of XP you have, so that's the amount of points of XP, not the amount of levels. And that's about all of the criteria that there is for Java Edition. So let's add one with armor. As I said, let's name it armor in this case, like this. Press the button, and now you see the chat created new objective, armor. Now you won't see this anywhere on your screen right now. It is now working, so if you put on armor, it will change its value, but you just can't see the value yet. And the easiest way you can see the value, if you go over to scoreboard, objectives, set display. Then there are a couple options. So here you see the options, below name, list, and sidebar. Of course, there's also sidebars for different teams, but that's only if you have teams, of course. So below name will show the amount of the scoreboard below your name. You can't see it yourself then. You have list and sidebar. So sidebar is just on the side. So let's set armor to the sidebar. There we go. You will see that we have this over here, armor, and my name with a zero value. Now if you put on some netherite armor, you will see that this value increases to 3, then to 9, and to 17, and then to 20. So this is the amount of armor points you have. So normally if you're in survival, you have this bar over here with 10 armor chest plate icons. And if you do this times 2, you will get the amount of points, because you can also get half bars, as you can see. So this is 17, and that correlates to the amount of armor you have on. Of course, the most frequent scoreboards people use is the amount of deaths you have. So let me now set that for you, so you can have that as well. So what you need to do is scoreboard, objectives, add death, like this, and then just death count like this, enter. And then we want to set it display, of course. So let's go over to scoreboard, objectives, set display, and let's do list this time. Now let's put deaths in under list. So this is, if you press tab, you will see the amount of deaths I have. So currently I have 0, but if I now die and respawn, you will see that if I press tab now, I have 1 death on the counter. Let's now actually set this to the sidebar. Here we go, sidebar, deaths. And now I'll show you how to actually manipulate this value. You can do this using scoreboard players. And now you can add, enable, and get. With get, you can get the value for different scoreboard. So for example, deaths, Maximilian V has one death. But what you can also do is remove and set and reset as well. So remove, you can remove a number of points. For example, we can remove one from deaths and it removes one. We can also set it to a certain value. So with some scoreboards you can do this, with others you can't. So with armor you can't set it, as it's just related to the amount of armor you have at a certain point in time, while deaths is after you've set the scoreboard. So we can set it to whatever we want, for example to 100, and then it sets my deaths to 100. If I die now, we will just go to 101, as you can see. And then you can also reset. Reset, of course, then you don't have to add a value at the end. Just do reset and it will set your value to zero and actually remove the sidebar entirely. So it's still there, so if you die, it will automatically display it. There we go. But it will just not say zero. Now I have another example over here, which you might find interesting. It's the amount of diamond ore a player has mined. And now this can be done very easily, of course, by just having this. Scoreboard objectives add diamond, mined, Minecraft, diamond ore. Like this. But you can cheat a lot with this, so you actually have to add some other stuff to it. And here I also show you how to actually get a name with spaces. So what you have to do is just give it a name, a random name over here, so diamonds. And at the end, add something like this. Of course, these commands are in the description below, so you can copy them over if you want to. So it just says text and then diamond or mined. So we can activate this, and now we created a new objective. Let's show it on the sidebar. Here you do need to use diamonds and not the name you gave it. So diamonds, and now it's set display, okay. If we now go to these diamond ores over here, grab a netherite pickaxe, go into survival, and I mine one of these diamond ores, you can see I gain one diamond ore mined. Mine more, and that's all fine. But there's a little problem, because if I get a silk touch pickaxe and mine this, you will see that I gain another diamond ore mine. But now I have diamond ore, right? So I can place it back down and mine it again. And this will increase the counter, which is not what we want, of course. So we can counter this with this command block over here. This one adds a new scoreboard objective, and this is dia ore place. So this is the amount of diamond ore I place on the ground, and this has a criteria used diamond ores. This is just if I right click a diamond ore on the ground, then this will increase by one. So let's activate that. So if I place down diamond ore, this one will increase by one. And then there's two repeating command blocks over here that actually do the work, that remove the amount of diamond ore I mined. So the first one, of course, once again, command is in the description, is an execute command, and it executes if the nearest player has a diamond ore place of 1. So once a player places diamond ore, this is true, and then it runs this command over here, so it removes 1 from diamonds. So it will remove 1 from diamond ore mined if I placed a diamond ore on the ground. Then also we need to remove it from dia place ore, so this is the same thing. If that value is 1, we will remove 1 from dia ore place as well. So now if I go back into survival, I mine some diamond ore. Of course, it increases if I mine it with silk touch, but once I place it back down, it removes one from the score. Of course, you get this message in chat. You just need to do game rule, command block output false, and then you won't see that anymore. So it just says that it removes one from the ore place and diamond ore mined both. Of course, you can go into the negatives because I had some more diamond ore lying around, but that doesn't really matter. It always keeps track of the right amount of diamond ore that you've mined. You can also remove these scoreboards, of course, by using scoreboard objectives, remove diamonds and the ore place. Click on this and both will be removed. And now let's just go over to better condition to show you what you can do over there. So, as I said, in better condition, there is less things you can do with the scoreboard command. So if you try to use it, scoreboard, objectives, add the name, you can only add dummy. As you can see, it's the only option they give you. So now if you press enter, we've added the objective. We can also set a display, of course, by doing this. Set display, three options once again. Let's do it on the sidebar, name. There we go. Now we have name on our sidebar, you can see it. And now we can change this only with commands. Go into scoreboard, players, and then there's a couple options. So you have add, list, operation, random, remove, reset, set, and test. So you can set it to a random value using random. So you have the minimum value here and maximum value as well. So minimum is 100 here and maximum 1000. You can set it to 1 and 1000 as well. And then it will set it to a random number between 1 and 1000, as you can see. You can of course also set it to a value, so set it to, for example, 400, that's also possible. You can add one to the value, and you can do all of these operations you see on the screen right now. So you can do something like this, and there's just lots of things you can do with operation that's a bit strange. But if you understand how it works, then you can work with that, of course. Most people will just use reset, set, add, and random, and remove, of course. You can also test if it's in a certain range, like this, and that will say yes, 401 is in a range from 100 to 500. So in better condition, there's not much you can do with it, but you can add buttons to your map that increase your score and stuff like that. Now just a quick little thank you to my first tier 3 member. Thank you, Xobot, for being my first tier 3 member. You can check him out with a link in the description. He gets a shout out in the description and in all the videos as long as he is a member, because he is a tier 3 member. If you want to know more about the memberships, click the blue join button below the video. But there we go. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope to see you in the next one. So until then, bye bye. Oh,